Hello everybody, my name is Mr. C. Ferrante, and today I'll be taking a look at the Murik Woods, Fiefdom Inhabitants Score, Flora Fauna Dangers, 0.5 out of 5. The forest is home to an array of beasts, but few, if any, are predatory towards humanoids. Natural Arai Phenomena, 1 out of 5. Irregular amounts of rainfall plague the region and cause floods, but this is easily avoided by sticking to high ground. Humanoid influences, 2.5 out of 5. Recent territorial struggles have made parts of this region active battlegrounds. Most combatants are human, so travel with caution. Ease of traversal, 4 out of 5. The terrain is exceedingly difficult to properly navigate without any maps or other guidance. Don't lose yourself. Summary. From A Traveler's Guide to the Half-Tamed Wilds, page 13. The Labyrinthine Forest. An important thing to remember about this part of the Midden Ground, dear viewer, is that the sights and sounds, while awe-inspiring for sure, are also your greatest enemy. This region is infamous for the array of geological lunacy that comprises the natural terrain. Here, the land twists and turns everywhere you look. Hills, valleys, mountains, karsts, mesas, arches, cliffs, bluffs, gorges, tunnels, canyons, pits, and vast cave networks are what makes up the forest, most of which seemingly stacked on top of each other. Navigating the boggling lands of the Murik would be a difficult task all of its own, but then one must also factor in the disorientation of trying to traverse the dense foliage and canopies that cover the landscape. Inhabitants past and present of the region are all too aware of this, and make use of the chaotic terrain in all manner of different ways. While there are plenty of well-traveled routes and roads that wind through the Murik, these routes often have twists and turns built into them, designed to throw off anyone the paths weren't intended for. Also found along these routes are points where such paths can be easily destroyed, such as tight passageways easily filled by rockfalls, or bridges spanning entire canyons that need only a single shot from a catapult to demolish entirely. Apart from the ease of losing yourself, and the risks imposed by some of the less than welcoming locals, the region is rather breathtaking. Few predatory beasts are present here, allowing for the more peaceful flora and fauna to develop in dazzling ways. Here one can see several species of bird with vibrant hues of plumage, small animals of all manner and shape running about underfoot, and schools of multicolored fish swimming to and fro. When night falls on the woods, or if one travels deep enough into the caves and crevices beneath the forest floor, a spectacle of glowing plants and fungi illuminate the Murik when sunlight is nowhere to be found. Tips to remember. Never travel blindly. For those not from the Midden Ground, you'd likely not want to get yourself lost a second time around, so why take the chance? If you're planning on traversing the Murik, then prepare accordingly. Stock up on food and supplies, and make sure you have at least one or two reliable means of finding your way around. Route maps can be found in most towns on the borders of the region, or at hubs of travel, and some towns even have guides that can be hired to get to and from specific parts of the forest. Never pass up on obtaining a vital means of navigation. Avoid dangerous routes. Even when you know the quickest way from point A to point B, it may be better to take the long way around rather than accept the risks. The region has a nasty reputation as being a hotspot for violent conflict between opposing settlements or kingdoms, and travelers regularly have to contend with bandits, traps, ambushes, and even snipers, all of which need only see visitors as potentially hostile forces to act. If that wasn't enough, the regular rainfall that plagues the region has been known to cause flooding in the lower parts of the forest that can shut off entire routes and leave travelers stranded. Remember to stick to high ground whenever possible. Avoid routes with easy spots for ambushes, and don't put yourself wide out in the open. Have a plan. The Murek is often seen as one of the most unpredictable and lively fiefdoms within the half-tamed wilds, and given the number of dangers, dense population, and lists of things that could go wrong or awry, travelers should have a plan of emergency action before traversing the forest. Carrying a concealed weapon and/or emergency medical supplies, establishing what to do or where to run in the event of a dangerous encounter, and accounting for any known threats along the routes you know you'll be taking are some of the easiest and best ways to prepare yourself ahead of time and have saved the lives of many a traveler. You never want to go into the forest without an emergency plan in place. Noteworthy locales. The Valley of Belber Dro consists of two city-states, Belber and Dro, both situated on opposite ends of one of the region's largest canyons. Both cities have a total population of around 35,000. Travel between each city is done with a system of sky trolleys, with boxcars suspended and carried over the canyon below by a network of cables and pulleys. Travel between each city by trolley takes roughly an hour, while moving by foot takes just over a week. The cities are seen as hubs of trade due to their position overlooking the canyon, where several high-traffic routes in the region converge. Routes leading to the cities or through the canyon are heavily guarded by thousands of armed soldiers. Reasons for visiting. Perfect spot for trade. Can find all manner of things being bought and sold in the local markets. Ikrath Spire, one of the largest karsts in the Murek, famous for the Bodian city of the same name that winds its way up the entirety of the spire. Home to a densely packed population of over 60,000. The height of the karsts and the lights from the city make it a veritable beacon rising above the forest, visible for hundreds of miles. Serves as the unofficial capital city of Bodia, with most of the kingdom's trade with other nations occurring here. One of the largest post offices in the Midden Ground is found here, with thousands of fire darts roosted here to deliver messages as far away as Igla Dun. Reasons for visiting. Easy to spot safe haven. Most roads leading to the karst are straightforward and not difficult to navigate, and a perfect place to go if you need a message sent anywhere in the half-tamed wilds. Kingdoms present and how to deal with them. The Sephardel Protectorate. Unless you are a penumbra, steer clear at all costs. If you come into contact with Sephardel forces, run. Do not engage whatsoever. Avoid any persons claiming to be from Sephardel, as common knowledge in the Midden Ground, you will find no friends in Sephardel. The Kingdom of Bodia. When dealing with Bodia, remember to remain civil and be careful not to commit any cultural fallacies. Bodians are very vocal about their intolerance for perceived slights. Don't stay on the kingdom's borders too long, as the Bodian borderlands are known for being riddled with violent conflict and guerrilla fighting. The kingdom will only accept their own minted currency, so remember to convert whatever coin you may have before crossing the border. The Gwilithmire Dominion. Unless you are human, best to steer clear of this kingdom. Be especially wary of the Gwilithmire forces, as they operate with some of the strongest human weapons throughout the half-tamed wilds. If you're not human, but find yourself inside the Dominion, keep your head down and get out as fast as possible. The Duchy of Shatterstone. Have plenty of coin on you before entering. Everything in the Duchy has a price. Avoid the Shatterstone Gwilithmire borderlands, as the duchy does not enforce their laws in the area, leaving the borderland rife with crime. The duchy is the only kingdom to have a relatively affordable system of transportation across the Murek, so try to take advantage of this luxury. Neighboring fiefdoms and phase points. The Murek Woods borders the following fiefdoms: the Sefer Isles to the southwest, the Fields of Ill Omen to the northwest, Felerath Hurst to the north, and the Wailing Reach to the east. There are three known phase points in the Murek. Toward the top of Ikrath's spire, there's a marble archway shrouded in faint green mist. Walk through the archway and you'll successfully phase to the Sephir Isles. Due 30 miles east of Belbridge Row is an abandoned mineshaft. Walk inside the doored entrance, close the door behind you, and snuff out all light sources. You should successfully phase to Khavragoth's Reach. Around the northernmost point of the Gwilithmyr-Bodia border is a patch of land about 1 square mile in size, where all foliage has a black hue. Wait there around 5 to 10 hours and your vision should temporarily go black. If so, you'll regain vision shortly and successfully phase to the Edderfoll Mountains.